Wendy Williams is one of many talk show hosts in the world today, but one thing that separates her from others is the fact that she lives to insult people, which may not seem out of place per se, but she's gone out of her way to go and insult various celebrities over the years, from actors to singers to other daytime talk show hosts and beyond. She's a menace in many ways, and that is shown perfectly when it comes to her insulting the guests that are there before her. Allow us to show you some of these times, but first, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. If you want the chance to win a brand new iPhone 12, MacBook Pro, or a $500 Amazon gift card, find the hidden message that's in this video, comment it down below, and subscribe to the channel for a chance to win one of these amazing prizes. Don't forget to hit that like button and good luck. Number 9, her own staff. It's never a good sign when the people that work for you don't like you. Now, yes, it's true that some of them could be disgruntled for stupid reasons, but for Wendy and the next person on our list, the beef the workers had with her was legitimate, and it played out in a hilarious fashion. Wendy Williams missed the first of what could have been many tapings of her eponymous daytime chat show in late December 2018, according to US Weekly. By mid-January 2019, Williams delayed her return to the show for a third time, revealing to fans that she required significant time spent in the hospital to battle complications regarding her Graves' disease, as well as a fractured shoulder, which, to be fair, is a legitimate thing and absolutely should be taken care of. Health comes before fame, or at least that's how it should work. In her absence, a slew of celebrity guest hosts, including Jason Biggs and Nick Cannon, spilled the tea for her to the delight of her devoted fans. This is a common thing when it comes to talk shows. Sometimes you can't make it, so you have someone fill in until you get back. Nothing wrong with that, right? Well, some of the folks in the studio audience weren't the only ones enjoying Williams' hiatus. Disgruntled show staffers told Radar Online, "It has been like a vacation having guest hosts. Everyone is laughing and smiling and working together. We all had gotten so used to walking on eggshells around Wendy and Kevin, Hunter, Williams' ex-husband and show producer, we forgot what a fun work environment was." Yep, that's a burn, and a sincere one at that. The staffer's beef with the gossip maven reportedly stems from her alleged diva behavior, like the claim that she would only interact with certain staff members. There were so many unwritten rules with working with Wendy, one anonymous staffer said, adding, "You never knew what mood Wendy or Kevin were going to be in." This proves all sorts of things about Wendy, not the least of which is that she's a terrible boss and that she makes people miserable around her. And that's even before the show starts. Think about that. She's already proving to be a mean person and diva before the cameras come on and her on-camera persona kicks in. Not a good sign, and there are more bad signs to come. Number 8. Ellen, while on Ellen. Wendy Williams has made a career of throwing insults and shade at people on her show and beyond, which has made her very popular in certain circles, yet it's also made her a target of those who didn't appreciate the shade. And to be clear, some of the guests we're going to show you did bite back at Wendy Williams. Regardless of that though, she was also at odds with Ellen DeGeneres because of her personality. As two of the top ladies of talk shows, they occasionally go onto each other's programs, including one time when Wendy went onto Ellen's show and things didn't go so well. Ellen asked her why she threw some shade at Kanye West and Kim Kardashian while they were expecting their first child. This was back in 2013, and Williams played it off. And then in support of Ellen, Williams applauded her veganism and her PETA support. But then she asked, "How can you live without bacon?" And I don't think I need to explain why that wasn't a good question to ask. Ellen wasn't amused with the question and went, "Well, because I think pigs are very smart animals." And when Williams came back a few years later, she made a joke that Ellen and Justin Bieber were said to look alike. Really? Sure, Ellen took it in stride, but she shouldn't have. And this is yet another perfect example of who Wendy Williams is. It doesn't matter if she's on another show, and she is the guest, she'll try and take over and make it her own because she has no desire to go and do anything else. It backfires on her and we'll get to laugh, so by all means, Wendy, keep being yourself. Number 7. Bashing Ariana Grande. In 2015, Williams was accused of body-shaming Ariana Grande, which, even if you only loosely know Grande and her various talents, that's not a good thing because of how popular she is. Plus, body-shaming as a whole is something to be frowned upon, which is no doubt why she did it, and did it in a classless fashion. She's 21. She'll forever look 12, Williams reportedly said, and I don't mean that in a good way. It's nice to look younger than you are, but when you look too young and you're short, she's only like 4'11". I don't look at her as like a woman. The comment fueled so much backlash that the hashtag #CancelWendyWilliams was trending. Her comments were so hated that fans flooded Twitter and got a cancel movement going, which is crazy, but it also shows both the love for Grande and the hatred from Wendy Williams' words, because they were indeed terrible. And while we should say that we're totally surprised by this behavior, and that this felt out of character, it didn't. Not even close. This is something Wendy Williams says because it sounded interesting in her head, and she absolutely had to go and say it to cause something or to get people to agree with her. Except they didn't. Not even close. They hated her for saying that and believed that she should be shamed for even stating that about Grande. A person who, for the record, may not be perfect, but hasn't done body shaming like that at all. Not to mention, body shaming is a major cause of mental illness and depression. What would have happened if Grande had a very bad mental reaction to that? Wendy could have broken the spirit of Ariana and it wouldn't have bothered her one bit. And if you think that's the only line she crossed, you're very wrong. Number 6, Method Man and his wife. We honestly can't believe that she did this, and yet we totally believe she did this. In 2006, Williams announced live on air that Method Man's wife had cancer. She did so not only without their permission, but before they even had the chance to tell their family and friends. That's not just tactless, that's classless, and a lot of people weren't happy that she did that, because that's a violation of privacy, among other things. The rapper recalled the moment telling All Hip Hop, Wendy gets on the air and said his wife is sick and she's not doing too well. And I'm like, this effing man, he went on, this is the big C for cancer. I was ready, I was so mad, I was crying right there, and I'm like, I'm gonna kill some effing body. And these Wu-Tang Clan friends kept me in there, kept me in LA. Williams also insulted that the I'll Be There For You rapper, who later dissed her in an online video, had an affair with his wife's doctor. She said me and the doctor was effing. What kind of is that, man? He said, you don't do that to nobody. You say the F you want to say about me, you say nothing about my family. So let's recap this for a moment, shall we? Wendy Williams somehow found out about Method Man's wife's cancer, then told the world about it without consulting them. Then after he dissed her about it, she went and said on air that he had an affair with the doctor. Does her depravity know no bounds? Clearly not, because there are several red flags here that should be enough to get rid of Wendy, and yet she just keeps going on because she feels she can. Number 5, Whitney Houston. This is actually a classic when it comes to Wendy Williams. The late Whitney Houston was a beloved figure in many ways, and not just because she had an amazing voice. She was special all around, but that of course led to her premature passing due to overdose and a coronary artery disease. And despite all of her fame and prominence, Wendy was not afraid to go after her in a big way. The former radio show host had a long feud with the legend. The two got into a heated argument on air in 2003 because Williams continued to press questions about Houston's alleged drug problem. Eventually, Houston said to her, if this were back in the day in Newark, I'd meet you outside. Now you can take this many ways, including Wendy doing her job to try and get Houston to confess to the problem that eventually took her life. But as in all things, there is a time and a place, and this wasn't it. And pushing constantly to get that was not just wrong, it was almost inhumane. Plus, if we're being honest here, we think it would have been fun to see Whitney throw down to try to teach Wendy some manners. But knowing Wendy, she would have just used it to promote herself and to further badmouth Whitney. The fact that Wendy is still around to insult people while Whitney can't bring joy to people anymore is a tragedy in and of itself. Number 4, Wendy versus the LGBTQ+ community. Not surprising to anyone at this point, Williams has a long history of making transphobic comments about transgender celebrities. In 2014, she drew fire for misgendering Chaz Bono during a conversation about trans athlete Chloe Johnson, who filed a lawsuit after the CrossFit Games refused to let her compete in the women's division. This is an unfair advantage, Williams said on the Wendy Williams show via The Advocate. You can take away female or male parts or whatever. It's like Chaz Bono, you know, Chaz is a man now, but I bet she still fights like a girl like the rest of us. And she's not as strong as a man who was born a man. There's so much wrong with that, it's hard to process it all, so we'll just keep going for now. Following swift backlash from the LGBTQ community, Williams apologized and cited herself as a long LGBT ally and at GLAAD supporter. However, 1 year later, Williams sparked outrage again after insinuating that Caitlyn Jenner wasn't a woman. While discussing a Cosmopolitan magazine cover that featured all the Kardashian women, Williams told her studio audience via People, no, not Caitlyn. Caitlyn still has a member. I mean, until you don't. Aren't you caught in limbo? See, this is exactly the problem. Wendy Williams doesn't care about being correct or sensitive, and when it comes to the LGBTQ+ members, that's what they need. They need people to treat them fairly and impartially and without false facts holding them back. They've only recently gotten progress in their movement for equal rights, and people like Wendy, who remember stated she was an ally to them, are people holding them back. Number 3, Leanne Rimes. After Williams commented on Leanne Rimes' relationship with Eddie Cibrian in 2010, the singer clapped back. All I know is Wendy Williams done pissed my mom off. I don't want to be in her path. To say I've reserved myself a place in hell? I'm incredibly disappointed to see someone with that kind of platform use it for such negativity and could be so mean and judgmental about a situation they know nothing about. Rimes reportedly wrote in a since-deleted tweet. She then allegedly added, I don't like how it happened either, said it a million times. But this is out of control. Rimes later apologized and even appeared on Williams' show. Such a wonderful time on At Wendy Williams Today. She tweeted in 2013, it airs on Wednesday. I adore her. Right. Something tells us this was a case where they needed to be bygones for some reason, possibly money. But it's hard to say. This was totally Wendy's fault though, because you never go after someone's partner and not expect them to clap back. Number 2, Sean Combs. Regardless of what his name is and isn't, Sean Diddy Combs is one of the most important people in rap history and a very powerful businessman who has earned his billion-dollar net worth. But when it comes to Wendy, yeah, they have a complicated history. Back in 1998, Williams suggested that Diddy might be gay, which led to him reportedly getting her fired from Hot 97, according to BET, which is very fair when you consider the accusation, the time period, and more. Who says something like that without having any proof of it? Wendy Williams, that's who. Number 1, Wendy versus Beyonce. Oh yeah, this happened, and you can already hear the backlash, can't you? Williams ruffled feathers when she trash-talked the End of Time singer in one of her more memorable Hot Topics segments in 2012. After sharing a preview of Beyoncé's HBO documentary, Life is But a Dream, the talk show host questioned the singer's intelligence. "I am a Beyoncé fan," Williams began via E! News. "I'm going to be watching this documentary, even if she doesn't introduce us to new stuff. I'm watching because fortunately one of the TVs in our kitchen has closed captioning, so I'll be able to understand what she says." At this point, her studio audience began to boo. "You know Beyoncé can't talk. Beyoncé sounds like she has a fifth grade education. She can't talk." Can't talk, huh? Her numerous awards and performances all over the world and interviews and appearances in movies and such would definitely disagree with you, Wendy. And there you have it, everyone, a look at Wendy Williams and all the various ways that she's insulted guests over the years. Can you believe that Wendy has said all these things to people who are supposed to be under her watch and care? Do you think this proves why she's a terrible host and should be ashamed of her actions? Which of these insults do you think was the worst? Or do you know of something she did that was worse? Go ahead and let me know in the comments down below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.